Namaste, I'm Smita Jayakar. Let's talk about gratitude today. Gratitude. Very often, we just very casually use the word thank you. When something nice happens in our life, we'll say, oh, thank God. So casually, isn't it? If you're traveling by a BST bus and a conductor gives you a ticket, you say thank you. When a guard opens the door for you, you say thank you. And when the divine does something for you also, you say thank you. How loosely do we use the word thank you? Do we really mean thank you to somebody? No. These two words, according to me, are the most useless words in the English dictionary. Thank you. For any little thing, we just say thank you. We really do not mean thank you to somebody. Thank you is gratitude, offering of gratitude. Gratitude is an emotion. It's not just those two words. I don't think that emotion has any word. If you really have gratitude towards anybody or even towards the divine, that gratitude will show on your face. You don't even have to say anything. Somebody who knows that you're feeling gratitude for this, it'll show on your face. It'll show in your actions. It's an emotion. The divine also loves this feeling of gratitude. If you're constantly in that feeling of gratitude towards the divine, you see how magically your life changes. And I mean it. All what I'm talking to you and saying to you is all my own experience. I'm not just rattling things out of a book. This is my own experience which I'm sharing with you. You start doing this. Start just thanking every moment of your life, whether it's good or bad, because you label it as bad from the divine plan. You don't know whether that particular incident was good in your life or was it bad in your life. We always live life in retrospect. We always say, oh, thank God that happened that time. Otherwise, I would not have been here today. So that time, probably that experience could have been a bad experience according to you. But because that bad experience happened, today you have transformed into what you are. So certain things in life play a catalyst role. The catalyst. People who come into your life, who say something to you, a catalyst in your life. So you have to be thankful to that. Because that happens, you take a step towards something else in life. There's a huge shift. And you have to say thank you at that time to those people. So when it comes to the divine, every time you offer your gratitude, things will change magically. I know a story on gratitude, on someone who always said thank you, whether it was good or whether it was bad. There was a king, and he had his commander kind of a fellow. And this guy used to advise the king for everything. Everything. The king never went anywhere without this commander, except maybe in the bathroom. So this man was there with him every time, and any time he spoke, went, even if he went for a walk, this guy used to be with him. All the time. One day in the night, when the king woke up, maybe to use the bathroom, he slipped and he broke his arm. The arm started bleeding and he called for the commander, oh, where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Please help me. This guy said, oh, you must thank the God for this. So he gets very angry with the commander. He said, oh, how dare you say this? Look at my hand, it's bleeding. And you're saying it's a good thing. Get out. So he throws the commander into the dungeon. He says, lock him up inside. I don't want to see his face. A couple of days go by and this king is tired of sitting inside in the palace because of his arm. So he decides to go for a walk one day outside. He goes for a walk. He goes on his horse and walks with the horse out. He's riding the horse and he doesn't realize he goes beyond the boundaries of the palace. He goes far away and some somehow he's in the midst of all the cannibals. And he says, oh my God, where have I come? These cannibals go to the king and they pull him down. And the cannibals are very happy. Oh, they've got somebody today to eat. So they're very happy and they're rejoicing and dancing and things like that. And when this king was supposed to be put in a skewer so that they can roast him and eat him, it is a formality with that cannibal group that they have to check the king if he is all perfect. And when they start checking him, they realize there's a bleeding wound on his arm. And when they realize that, they say, oh, we don't want an injured person. And they refuse him and they say, oh no. They put him back on the horse and send him back to the palace. The horse comes back to the palace. And the king is petrified of this kind of an incident. Because he would have been eaten up. That would be the end of him that day. He comes back and he realizes what the commander had said. He said, thank God for whatever happens. He calls the commander and says, I'm sorry, I'm very sorry that I put you in the dungeon. Because of this wound today, I'm saved. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. But tell me one thing. I put you in the dungeon. How was that good for you? You say everything is good. Everything is good. All that God does is perfect. How is it good for you? So he said, sir, I go everywhere with you. Had I gone with you that day, I am absolutely perfect. The cannibals would have taken me. Because you were wounded, they left you, but they would not have left me. So thank God you put me in the dungeon and I am safe also. So that's what is gratitude. Certain incidences you may feel are bad, not good, but you do not know the divine plan. So, my request to you, my humble request to you, always be in gratitude.